Hello. As you may know, I've recently been able to play on the global test server for the latest character Yoan in Tower of Fantasy, and I spent so much time testing. I think I've tested at least around 15 different comps, and this video will just show you what I was able to get on each of those different comps. There was about, I think it was like 5 or 6 in martial artist, and the rest were in the sweeping strike form. Though keep in mind that these were from an earlier version of the test server, and they may not exactly be the same as what you can expect from the final release. So please keep that in mind, and stay tuned at the end for a comparison between not everything, because there's quite a lot going on in here, especially since the cactus itself won't tell you the full story when you're actually fighting an enemy with resistances. And another thing to keep in mind is all the actual stats and equipment remain the same. The only thing that's changed is the weapons and matrices used, though the stats will show up on screen during the actual gameplay of each comp. And another thing to keep in mind is I've had 0 Titan stats, so I had no weak point, no skill damage, no domo attack, no discharge bonus, or anything on the test server. So these would be like, you know, the lower end of the numbers to expect, right? Also because my attack and crit isn't as high as others. But another thing to keep in mind is every single matrix used on the weapons here, they've been tested at 4-piece at 3-star. And I hope you guys enjoy. Wow, that was absolutely incredible. Just how versatile Yulon is. It was a ton of fun messing around on the test server. I spent over 30 hours just testing Yulon in various different ways. It was, like, pretty crazy, right? I can't believe I did all that in, like, 4 days, even, just of how much fun I was having just trying it out, right? There's so many possibilities you can do, especially with the Sweeping Force form, because any weapon with a low cooldown or, like, a highly spammable skill like Fenrir or Icarus can perform incredibly well. Heck, I put a little chart here. I didn't bother going through all the comps. These are just some of the more noteworthy ones. So when you factor in enemy resistances, Fenrir gets incredibly close to the Icarus numbers, which is, like, absolutely insane. So for any of those who skipped out on Icarus, because I know there's a ton of you guys out there, hey, if you have a Fenrir, maybe you consider picking up Yulon. Or, you know, maybe you aren't a Frost player, right? But again, Volt players with Fenrir, why not give her a shot? It'll help you out with Sequential and many other contents. It's really a ton of fun. And it looks like, you know, Fenrir is just back for revenge with the Rainbow comp, just like she was back during her release with Sunky. You know, it really does feel like Fenrir is secretly just a Frost unit. And all that aside, thank you guys all for watching. Hopefully, you can leave a like in the video if you liked it. Maybe subscribe if you loved it. And hopefully, I can see you guys again next time. I stream almost daily for the most part, around 11 p.m., sometimes starting at 12 a.m. Eastern. Or you can find me on the YouTube on the live tab, or even my Twitch, as well as Kick. Right, links to all of those are in the description below. And if you'd like to leave a donation, there's a link for that there too. And for any of you guys who whale in these sorts of games, consider topping up using my affiliate link on Moogold. Especially for Tower of Fantasy, it is actually cheaper to top up through them, especially if you have to VPN through regions like Thailand to pay in their currency, because it is considerably cheaper than the US dollar pricing or a bunch of other region pricings. So that would just save you time. It'll help me out, and it should make it a lot easier for you guys as well. And as well as if you're looking for something else to watch, I do have a VOD of when I was streaming Yulon live. I didn't even notice that I was being griefed until much later during the stream, but you can go watch, see a link to that there. And as well as another link down below as well, you can find the Icarus verse, because I didn't bother including the numbers that you see, you saw on the chart with my Icarus comp before Yulon, as the video was already getting extremely long, and I figured, you know what, I'll just put a link later so that you guys can see it separately, because again, the video is about Yulon, not the old Frost comp. But yeah, see you guys next time, hopefully. Bye.